everybody down.
You okay?
Yeah.
I was smuggled into South Korea at age 17 with forged papers. During my entire career in the Navy, I was an agent for North Korea.
Why do you want to defect?
My life's work has been about giving an advantage to those who care more about weapons and warfare while ignoring the needs of their own people. I don't want my legacy to be about death and destruction.
Sure, that's what happened.
Here's the part that really gets me, okay? If all these women are rocking the Merkin, that means there is somebody on that set that has to glue that shit on in the morning and take that off at the end of the day. If you're that guy, what do you even tell people when they ask you what your job is? Or hey, my name is Bob and I glue on fake hair on actresses' veg. Right? And what do you even get credited as? Are you the Bushmaster? And how much money does a Bushmaster actually make? And more importantly, how do I get that job?
Oh my God. Why would someone do this?
When was the last time you saw him?
Yesterday. He took the boat out for a short run and got into some nice fish that I took to market.
Did you notice anything that was out of the ordinary?
Yeah. Found my laptop on. The only reason I noticed because I checked the weather first thing. My pops was old school. No cell phone, no computers.
Well, it took him so long to send us one of y'all. Ever since you people joined the Confederate Alliance, you can sign up for the Navy in droves.
Well, it has taken some time.
Well, I better show you what's what. So, right this way is astrometrics. Over there is weapons control. That's going to be your hangout. Right over here is medical. Straight ahead is computer core. And right around the corner is the crew quarters. If you really want to have some fun, right there is what we like to call the party. Ha ha.
Party room?
Yeah, it's a little nickname for the officer's lounge. Now, you gotta be careful, because just last week, Mooney got mad at Johnny for kicking him out, so he rigged the entire thing to give an electric shock to whoever enters. Woo! That is one man whom you don't want to stand between him and his whiskey. No, sir.
And how do you know that? Oh, the one wonton among the tortillas?
I would have said kimchi and the salsa.
That's good. See, the Hannigan were slaves from Korea brought over to Mexico to work in plantations.
I know.
He's a history buff.
And some people think that I'll be offended if you point out the incongruity.
Well, I assume you want it pointed out.
And why would I want that?
Because it suggests you're very good at what you do.
I think Mr. Picker told you we require payment up front.
He did, but we were hoping to come to a different understanding.
Well, fortunately, the people I represent rely on me precisely because they know I'm not like them. I dislike beheadings, gentlemen.
So do we.
It's bad for business. And the fact is, money in that bag would only buy you insurance against my employers feeling taken advantage of if anything should go wrong in our transaction. So I'm willing to proceed without it. I do want to make sure you understand that my employers will never let anything jeopardize their reputation as men not to be crossed. And if at any point that reputation needs to be reestablished, it won't be me they send.
Hi, where's the carnival? It's like Burning Man. What can I get you? Some acai bowls, smoothies?
Yeah, please, like that one, please.
The gut buster?
Yeah, definitely. Finish it in under 30 minutes, then it's free.
That is true.
What's in the gut buster?
You ready for this? So you must eat everything inside the bowl and on the plate. That includes ice cream, brownies, waffle cones.
What is this?
Oh, that's just a standard contract.
And how many people have lost their eyeballs?
I mean, this month we're all time. Hey, you have 30 minutes to finish this challenge.
I am looking forward to this.
Ready, set, go, go, go! Section 10 of the contract says vomiting voids the win.
Keep it down, babe. You can do it.
It's up to you. There's a bucket right there.
Good. He's fine. You got this.
You have to hold it.
I'm
God,
sorry.
That doesn't sound good.
Inspector.
Agents, I owe you an apology. You were right. I rushed to judgment.
We understand this wasn't the first time you've crossed with Gunwoo.
Yeah. I've watched as he's grown bolder and more brutal over the years. I was assuming that his father's influence would protect him. But that doesn't excuse the fact that I refused to listen, and that almost cost another innocent woman her life.
Inspector Kim, we all agree that Gunwoo is a terrible person who deserves to pay for what he did.
Which is why I reached out to the ambassador. Gunwoo is being extradited to Dubai as we speak.
He'll face charges for what he did to that woman, plus extra penalties because he's a fugitive of the law.
You are as good as they say. I'll remember that next time we meet.